We tell you what you need to know ahead of the United States 2018 midterm elections.
Unborn babies deserve protection. You can make the difference. Vote pro-life.
Millions of Americans prepare to vote in the midterm election on Tuesday, November 6th. A large number of House, Senate, and governor's races are held in the middle of a president's term, hence the word midterms. All 435 seats in the U.S. House of Representatives will be voted on, 35 seats in the Senate, and 36 states will vote for governor. Joining us now to break it all down is Marilyn Musgrave, a former U.S. representative for the state of Colorado and currently the vice president of government affairs for the Susan B. Anthony List. Congresswoman, it's great to have you back.
It's wonderful to be here.
Looking at these midterm races, which ones will have the greatest impact on the pro-life movement?
Well, there are a lot of great pro-life heroes that are running. I think of Mia Love, and I look at her race. It's incredibly close. I look at Marsha Blackburn, who's running for the Senate. Both of these ladies have been in our National Pro-Life Caucus. And they are in races that are so tight. There's so much at stake here. I look at Kathy McMorris Rogers in Washington State. That's not an easy place to be pro-life. But Kathy has beautiful little Cole and her other children. He's Down syndrome. I know you've had her on the program. She's a wonderful pro-life leader and the highest ranking Republican woman in Congress. Her race is incredibly tight. So we have these races that there is so much at stake. And then the United States Senate, you know, we don't have 60 votes in the Senate, even though we've had a pro-life House of Representatives that's passed great legislation. We still haven't had that 60 vote margin in the Senate, and we're hoping to add there. And again, Catherine, you look at these races, you look at Indiana, you look at Montana, you look at Arizona. You know, we have a great pro-life lady, Martha McSally, running in Arizona. We have Matt Rosendale, pro-life man in Montana, running against Tester. In West Virginia, we have Patrick Morrissey that's running against Joe Manchin. And Joe Manchin says he's pro-life, but his voting record does not reflect that. And again, these races are neck and neck, and here we are getting close to the finish line.
In addition to candidates, there are also a few issues on the ballot concerning the life issue. Can you highlight some of those?
Yes, there are three of those. There's one in Oregon that has to do with banning taxpayer funding of abortion. Again, that's a very tough state for any kind of pro-life initiative. There's one in Alabama on taxpayer funding of abortion and rights of the unborn child. And the one that Susan B. Anthony List is really honed in on is in Virginia, in West Virginia. Mm. And that one would ban taxpayer funding of abortion. Several years ago, the state Supreme Court made a decision that caused the taxpayers of West Virginia, and this is a pro-life state, mm-hmm. caused the taxpayers to have to fund abortion to the tune of about $10 million and 35,000 abortions of precious children. And so this ballot initiative is very important to us because we're already there. We have 75 canvassers. We've visited over 50,000 homes, and we're telling people about how Senator Joe Manchin votes on the life issue, and we're also informing them about the ballot initiative.
So it's important that our viewers look to see what their candidate's stance is on life, but also look to see if there are any initiatives like this on their ballot.
That's absolutely true.
Congressman, you, as I mentioned, were a former U.S. representative for Colorado. Pro-lifers have had control of the U.S. House of Representatives for a few years now. So if that shift were to change, and as some forecasters are predicting that it might change to be in control of pro-choicers, what would that look like in the House of Representatives?
Well, I have to tell you, I was in Congress when the Democrats took control, and we did have a couple of faithful pro-life Democrats, Colin Peterson, Dan Lipinski, Henry Cuellar, when I was in Congress, Dan Burton. But still, when Nancy Pelosi became Speaker, it was like night and day. Absolutely nothing on the life issue. No pro-life bills will ever be heard. Mm. And when it comes to appropriations, where pro-lifers get the riders, that's congressional speak for amendments to the appropriation bills, where we get our pro-life wins, mm-hmm. none of those would be happening. None under Nancy Pelosi, who would likely be the speaker. So it's a different world for the life issue. We've made such progress in the House of Representatives. You know, we're looking to the day that we have 60 votes in the United States Senate. But defunding Planned Parenthood, redirecting those dollars to providers that do not perform abortion but provide comprehensive health care for women, you know, passing the 20-week bill, banning abortion after the fifth month of pregnancy, born alive legislation, you know, helping that precious child that has survived an abortion, giving it medical care. Those kinds of things will not be happening if the House goes to the Democrats under Speaker Pelosi. Believe me, it's a different world.
A lot rides on this election. Marilyn Musgrave, Vice President of Government Affairs for the Susan B. Anthony List, thank you for your insight this week.
You're very welcome.